big risk. Incremental changes won't take us to where we want to reach. Today, let us listen to the success story of Rohit Kumar, Wealth and Asset Management Leader at EY GDS Consulting. Hi Rohit, thank you for joining us.
Thank you, my pleasure.
So Rohit, can you share with us how did you start your career journey?
Sure. So I started my career pretty early, at the age of 19. I started with India's Space Research Organization, but I quickly realized that I wanted to do something more different. I then moved to the IT world in Bangalore, and then worked at Infosys for about 5.5 years as a programmer. As an engineer, always had this itch to do an MBA, and then quickly realized that I wanted to do something even more different, and applied to a lot of business schools in the US, and that's how I went to do my full-time two-year MBA program in the US, and have been in consulting ever since.
Wow, that's really interesting, and the kind of turns you've taken, and that very quickly. I'm so glad you've been realizing where your interest lies so quickly. Very, very interesting. So when did you join EY?
I started with EY in November of 2010. And I've been with the firm ever since. When I started with EY in the US, I was the third and the junior most person in the wealth and asset management industry sector team. When you're the junior most in the team, I quickly realized that I was doing the client relationships, business development, delivery, and a whole lot of other things. I've also come to believe that you're always learning through your toughest experiences. And that has been the defining moment for my journey, where throughout my EY career, my roles have continuously evolved, and even today as a partner, I continue to keep learning and evolving.
That's really nice. Rohit, you have really changed organizations and worked on various different kinds of technology, and I'm sure you are observing technology trends very closely. It would be really nice if you could share with us some top three technology trends that you see in the market currently.
Absolutely. As we speak, existing technologies are getting obsolete. New technologies are coming in the market all the time. There are three top technology trends that I see impacting the financial services industries in particular, which is where I and my teams work. First is cloud. EY itself is one of the largest consumers of cloud. Our entire IT information systems all run on cloud. We see the same trend with our clients. Large-scale transformation and migrations to cloud is how we're seeing a lot of our business being driven. Second top trend is artificial intelligence, or AI. We are seeing AI being leveraged for building intelligent products and services for our clients. Data analytics plays a big part of how all information and all products are used and consumed. And third is metaverse. New as this technology is, it is expected to add up to $5 trillion to the global economy by 2030. We expect metaverse to play a big role in financial services, the banking industry, and wealth and asset management industry. We see our clients already making large investments in virtual reality and augmented reality.
Great. So when you're looking at these changes, I'm sure even the career landscape is changing, and more so for students who are, you know, looking to join their careers, and how do you think this changes for them, and what is it that they need to observe, and what is it that they need to learn?
Absolutely, great question. If I put myself in the shoes of a new campus hire or somebody who's expecting to get a job in today's market, there are probably three things that I would advise students. Number one, look at expanding their network. Mentorship and guidance along the way throughout your college journey and after college in your career journey is extremely critical for all of us to succeed. Second, do a lot of reading and research. Never underestimate the value of what you can impress your new bosses, your new teams, and your team members with with research you have done that they would not have expected you to do. And third, no work is ever too small. When you're coming to join a new job, when you're entering the workforce, keep your egos aside. A lot of times, young freshers, campus joiners, have very set mindset on what they want to do and what they don't want to do. That, unfortunately, can always be a showstopper in terms of their own career progression. Those would be the three things that I would advise people to do.
Great. So Rohit, what are the career opportunities that you see for youngsters, I mean the freshers or students at EY GDS?
See, as a Big Four, EY logo takes you a long way in your career. We are experiencing a transformative growth in our markets, particularly in the sector that I am in within financial services and wealth and asset management. We're experiencing explosive growth. Extrapolating that, the opportunities that it presents for young students or, you know, young professionals entering EY, the opportunities are tremendous. Sky is the limit, be it in the business, technology, or operations space. Our clients have an insatiable demand, even in a softening global macroeconomic environment, to leverage EY services as a trusted partner and as a trusted brand. So I see opportunities to be tremendous for us.
Great. So Rohit, I'm sure EY GDS also does a lot in terms of growing this particular kind of youngsters or the young talent. And you as a leader also must be following certain things that you do with your team. So if you could share with us, what is it that three things that you, work out with your team or do with your team in terms of improving them or helping them grow?
Absolutely. We are in a client-centric business. So for me, it is very important that whatever we are doing, we keep our clients first in mind. At the same time, our biggest assets are our people. So between taking care of our clients and managing the aspirations of our people, these are the two primary driving factors for me as a leader and for most of us at EY. With that in mind, there are kind of three things that I always advise and coach my team members on. Number one, think from the shoes of your clients. What is keeping them awake at night? What is that we can do proactively to preempt the issues that they're facing? That is what makes you from being a partner to being a trusted relationship partner. Number two, as I mentioned before, research on your domain is critical for us all the time to keep abreast with all what's happening in the market. Clients do not care whether it's a junior person in the team or a senior member. They're thinking and talking to us as EY professionals, and there is a certain level of expectations that come with it. As a result, all of us need to constantly keep ourselves abreast of what's the latest that is happening around us. So always keep researching and reading. And third and for but equally important is a healthy mind can only reside in a healthy body. So we can do all of the great things that we talked about only if we have a strong mental and physical well-being. At EY and in GDS, we do a lot of things in terms of helping mental, physical well-being of our employees as well as their extended families. So my advice to all my colleagues and team members always is always to stay fit.
Sure. Thank you so much, and I think that's a very nice way to end this talk, saying a healthy mind and a healthy body, really is the key to success. And thank you so much for sharing your thoughts, Rohit. And I'm sure people watching this video also have really enjoyed our conversation and are looking forward to hear more from EY GDS. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks, Maren. Thank you for having me.